switch it up too. We can go throwback on him.
What can wash away my sins?
Y'all don't want something.
Nothing but the blood of Jesus. And what can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood is I'm singing all.
I know I could pull the choir out. I could do.
Yeah! Oh, just clap your hands like that.
See the day that the Lord has made. That the Lord has made.
Oh, y'all know that one, don't you? Come on and say it. Glad in it.
That's it. That's a bop. We can go Maverick.
I can do it all. We're versatile over here. What do you think?
Yes, I'll give you everything. Sing.
I'm versatile on it.
But listen, y'all know I gotta get the vibes right every video. Y'all know the vibes.
Listen, if you clicked on the video, I know what you're here for. I'm not gonna waste your time anymore. How to actually get closer to God. Make sure I like, comment, subscribe. Like the video. I know it's gonna be a great video. So like it. Make sure somebody else can see it. Help somebody out. Help me out. Like the video. Subscribe. I don't know why you haven't subbed yet. You've watched my last 4 videos. You're not subscribed. That's crazy. I'm not gonna take it personal. You do it one more time though, you might have a problem. I think a lot more people should tell you this. And I think it's one of the first things you need to hear as a newfound believer in God, or someone who's not even just a new believer, but someone who's really taken that journey towards their walk in faith. The first thing I want to tell you is I am extremely proud of you. You've come a long way, and for you to even be here is beautiful. To make the decision that I want to change, and not only do I want to change, but I want to do it God's way, the right way, it's a beautiful thing. And I applaud you, and I'm extremely proud of you. All right, my second point, follow God's word and understand true repentance. A lot of pastors say, oh, make a 360. I don't want you to do a 360. Do a 180. I don't want you to turn back around. I want you to turn completely away. That's what repentance is. True repentance is to turn away. I remember when I was a kid, I used to just say, God, I repent every night. And go back to do the same thing and think I was fine. I used to think that if God came back, if Jesus came back, or I died and I didn't repent that night, I was going to hell. That's how I thought it was, but that's another thing. I'm gonna get into that. You gotta repent. You gotta turn away. This is a new life. It's a new journey. And a lot of people tell you that this journey is hard. But truthfully, I wanna tell you something that's contrast to that. It's actually very easy. Now I know what you're thinking. Oh, he's trying to sound like he perfect or whatever. That is not at all what I'm saying. As humans, we don't like easy. We prefer difficult. In the Bible, God says, my yoke is easy, my burden is light. We don't like easy. You know what easy would be?
Yeah.
Not stressing, not applying to 90 jobs, and trusting that God will just bless you with a job, and trusting that God is going to keep you on your way. You know what hard is? Searching for jobs when God has told you, I got you, and you continue searching and searching and talking to people, stressing, anxiety, stress, anxiety, and God is telling you, chill, I got you. We like difficult. You know what else would be easy? Not to date that guy that God has told you is taking all your money, giving you all your stress, giving you all your anxiety. It's way easy to not have stress and anxiety, but we like difficult, so we're going to go date the person. Us humans, that's our sin nature. We like difficult. God is what's easy. So when people say your walk with God is hard, flip it. We're difficult. He's very easy. So yes, understand repentance is truly to turn away. My third point, relationship is greater than religion. A lot of people, when you start your Christ walk, are going to plant in your head a lot of religious ideology. Jesus wasn't religious. Jesus taught on relationship, not religion. a lot of religious people are going to tell you, hey, you can't do this, you can't do that, you can't do this, you can't do that, you can't do this, you can't do that. And not all of that is Bible. Yeah. Not all of it is biblical. And I think we got to stop doing that, especially planting these unrealistic expectations on newfound believers. It's crazy. It's a crazy thing that these Pharisees in church do. Like, for instance, you probably clicked on this video and said, he's got a ski mask on his head. It's probably not for style. What is he going to tell me about my relationship with God? That's religion. Thinking that a ski mask is somehow against God. Like God cares that I have this ski mask on my head. That you care, not God. And don't place your unrealistic earthly expectations on me and call it God. But understand your relationship with God is one-on-one. Do y'all know why celebrities don't post their new boo or their new girl or their new boyfriend instantly or even tell you at all? Because once all these different people in TMZ and Shade Room, once all these other people get in it, it becomes 10 times more difficult when everyone's got an opinion versus one and two. And it's the same thing with God. When everyone gets in your relationship with God, it's so much more difficult because you don't know whether you're hearing something from him or him or him or him or him or God. And then you start mixing the two. And man, that's an awful place to be. One-on-one, your relationship with God, not anyone else's. My next point, understand that what you put in is what you get out. So whether you're watching social media, watching a bunch of bad stuff, listening to a bunch of bad stuff, what you get in is what you get out. Now listen, everyone has their own personal conviction. Everyone has their own ideologies. I will not sit here and tell you that all secular music is 100% a sin. All secular TV is 100% a sin. I will not tell you that. I cannot sit here and tell you that Beethoven is a sin. Listening to Beethoven, I don't know how that's sinful. I'm gonna just give you an example. I'm gonna keep it a bean with y'all. When you get married, God says the marriage bed is undefiled, which means it's a no holds bar once you're married. You can do whatever you want in that marriage bed, but I'm not married, so I ain't gonna talk about that. I don't think God wants you to go in your bedroom and make love to elevation worship. Like, I don't think that's realistic. I think love songs are a beautiful thing. Songs of Solomon is a love song. It's literally songs. They're literally love songs. Now, I will say some music is not beneficial to you. And I also will say, understand your tolerance. I can listen to certain stuff that my mom can't listen and it doesn't affect me, but you have to be self-aware in order to do this. This is another thing. Like my point said, what you put in is what you get out. You should always be putting more God into your ears than earthly thing or into your eyes than earthly things. So, like I said, I'm not saying that all secular music is bad or that you shouldn't do it. I'm just saying, watch your ears, watch your heart. Guard your ears, guard your heart. Another thing with music, if you want music that can substitute for what you've been listening to, I will put two links down in the description below. One being my gospel, contemporary, just so many songs to choose from, very wide discography. Click that link, it's called Heavenly. Then I have another one called A Real Talk, which is my gospel, Christian, whatever, godly rap favorite songs. Now I have one with hundreds of songs on there, but I don't want to give that to y'all. It's not really, I like bangers. So I'm gonna drop those two links down below. Let me know what y'all think about. Another thing, join a church home. If you can't find one around you that you like, watch it. Fellowship is so good. The Bible says confess your sins to one another. Fellowship is such a beautiful thing. So I know you're probably thinking, drop, what do I read? I'm gonna tell you what you should start with. Everybody that has ever asked me about God in my life, I've told them to do this because I do the same thing and I still read it. A chapter, that's really long. One chapter, that's a long time. You spend 2 hours on your phone. You spend 2 hours on your phone every day and you can't spend 5 minutes with God. I'm gonna let you do with that information as you wish, but you know, to each his own. Read a proverb a day. It's 31 of them. There's 31 chapters. The day I'm filming this video, what is it? It's August 6th. Dang, it's August 6th. Summer went by mad fast. Dang, that's wild. It's August 6th. So today I would have read Proverbs 6. Boom, very simple. It's the book of wisdom. It applies to real life and it'll definitely help conform your mind in the process. It takes 24 days for something to finally become a habit. In order to become a habit, at first, it has to be disciplined. You might not like it at first, but you gotta keep going. And then you're gonna feel like it's a part of you. That pattern isn't part of you. Which takes me into my next point. Don't be complacent. Continue to press in. I've said this in my last three videos, dang near. You gotta press in any relationship in life. especially with God. I'm gonna give you the same example I gave in my last video. In order to get closer to your friend or your best friend, you had to start texting them, and then you started going to their house, and then you started playing on basketball teams together, and then you started going places together. You built that relationship by pressing in. You didn't just stay texting each other, because y'all wouldn't be nearly as close as if you just texted each other or just talked to each other in school. You gotta press in. Yeah. And that's the same thing with God. For 2 years, I was reading my Bible every day. Every day. Didn't miss a day. Kid you not. And I know you're probably gonna clap it up. Yay, yay. No, not at all. And on my second year, I felt like I was slipping. I felt far from God. And I didn't know why. And I'm thinking to myself, I'm reading a chapter a day. I've been doing this. And then I thought, it's not enough. I've gotten complacent. So then I started doing 2 a day, and then 3 a day, and then 4 a day, and then 5. And then to where I am now. And I'm gonna get into that next. If one isn't good enough for you anymore, you feel like you need to challenge yourself and go, maybe do a fast. Start reading something else. Maybe read more. Maybe read 2 different things at one time. Maybe balance it. Press in. Don't be complacent. I would say this like a second level type of thing after you've done the Proverbs thing. I would say do this thing called the Thirsty 30. Shout out Mike Todd. He's the one that put me onto this. Mike Todd does this thing called the Thirsty 30, and I've been doing it for some time now. 30 minutes total with God a day. It's a big step up from the 5 minutes of Proverbs I told you about. Yeah, but 30 minutes is nothing compared to what you do all day. So, hey, it's 10 minutes of praise and worship, 10 minutes of reading your Bible, and 10 minutes of prayer. Every day. Now, I usually try not to split them up, but sometimes you can split them up or do 10 here, 10 there, whatever you got to do. But 30 minutes with God a day. I've been doing it, and it's definitely working for me. My 8th point, you are now set apart. Understand it and act like it. Don't act the same, and don't act the same as everyone else. You're changed, so act like it. If that's not self-explanatory, I don't know what is. My final point. I'm gonna read this one word for word. Jesus is always there. He loves you and is the ultimate one to talk to in your journey called life. He's always there for you. Always. In this walk that you're about to begin, he is the one who you should talk to the most. Because you know why? He understands. Chandler Moore has a song called He Understands. Jesus went through everything that we all went through. And with that, that'll close out my video. I love you all. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, like the video, share the video to someone who you know needs it. Help somebody out. I love you. God bless you. And I'll catch you in the next one.